As KRDO News Channel 13's Eric Fink tells us, in this election year, the district could be fighting long odds.
These sixth graders at North Junior High are just getting comfortable with the first few days of science class.
Maybe you like to draw, write lists, or doodle in order to learn.
The district's nearly 30,000 student body started school almost a week ago. But moving forward, D11 will need funding to properly educate all of its students inside and outside of the classroom.
It's been over a decade since we have gone to voters for any kind of tax initiative.
The district is considering a more than $32 million levy that would go in front of voters for more school resource officers to hire teachers and upgrade technology. In addition, D11 is thinking about putting forward a $235 million bond issue that would include upgrades to buildings, infrastructure, and remodeling. Tax questions are always risky, and the district knows this one in particular could be a tough sell. You see, 80% of homeowners who live in District 11 either no longer have kids in school or don't have kids at all.
Strong schools mean strong community, and strong community means a better neighborhood. It means higher property values. It means less crime in your neighborhood.
Homeowner and educator Barbara Buswell is a yes.
Schools are so critical in our community, and we've been really fortunate in our neighborhood to have a great school, and I think the children do well, and I feel like it's the best way we can really invest in the future of our community and in today.
While these students are several years away from getting to cast a ballot themselves, the future of their education could get a boost if their neighbors agree. Eric Fink, KRDO News Channel 13.